This week and next week would be the last. I want to say something important. Next week, ya shabab, this is an announcement for me, for all the students, not you. Next week, on Sunday from 12 to 1, I'm going to make a revision for the lab assessment, the final lab assessment. And again, I will say this is clearly. Wallahi, I don't have any idea about the exam. I just try to guess how the question will come, because you don't have an idea how is it. Most of you, because your exam is not actually lab. Your exam is going to be theoretical part. So for example, in the X-ray experiment, I'm going to ask you a little bit about the X-ray. What they are used, what is the energy, blah, blah, how we generate it. Just like it. You remember last time, the last thing that we talk about is the mutual force or electrostatic force between two different charges, and also the electric field. This was the last topic that we covered. Just only to refresh your memory, we took that F, the force itself, is equal to K, Q1 times Q2 over R squared. And we say, this is here, we take always the absolute value for a reason. This is only get the magnitude and the direction shown by repulsion or attraction. Also, we mentioned that E itself, the electric field, is nothing but the force acting on a discharge. So it is K Q over R squared. Okay? One Q, here they are Q1 and Q2, and we just talk about it. Now, I need to say something, Geshe-la. Sometimes we may have some uses of the electric charges and we need to store a large part of it. Just like what? Always in a in the emergency rooms, ER rooms, in hospitals, there's a device that it's used to refresh the heart beating of the thing. Okay? It's called by the filtration system. This part, what is it simply? All of us, we can. Yeah, there is something, there is two electrodes, which is kept at the chest of the patient. When his heart stopped working, as we said. So what happened? Now you charge this one. When you charge it, you keep it a little bit for a few seconds, till it gives some charge or fail with the charge. Then suddenly what happened? You discharge it. Tishhan would fail, right? These type of electricity or charges, that charging and discharging, is used for activation of the heart beating, because your heart is a form of muscle. If that muscle simply activate, it can go back to work. This is what happened for the first aid even sometimes, and just like the ER rooms. So this is the first one. Now, what is the device here, this one? I'm gonna explain this for you. I lost my tech memory. Wow.
So let's start with this one. This is the lecture material. It's okay, you know it. I will go through it first. Now, this device I'm talking about, you know that it's called what here is the fibrillator. It's used to restoring a heart beating as you. Now, there is something you should know. Inside your cell, there is always a potential energy or a potential, certain potential. That potential is different from the cell inside and outside. So simply, we affect by the electricity. And this is, we are going to study that here. There is some here, the cell membrane potential, there is some inside the cell and there is outside the cell. There is some electricity going there, right? So this is, we will study now today more and more details about it. Let me show you. First of all, we have what we call by the apparent plate capacity. Capacitor written summation of MKF. Simply, that capacitor is nothing. It's two plates like these, parallel to each other, and they are spaced by a dielectric material or insulator. Mainly it is air. You know that air is a good insulator, right? So, if we connect this one to the positive and this one to the negative, pay attention. All the electrons here, they will attract to the positive. So what happened to this one? It will become positively charged, okay? All the electrons, they are moving to the positive. Here, all the electrons from the negative electrode, they will move to this. So this is what there will be? Yes, this process where the accumulation of positive charge in one electrode or one plate, and at the same time, accumulation of negative charge in the, this is called charging of a capacitor. It takes some time for it, according to the capacity. Capacity, if we have a large capacitor, it takes more time than the smaller one. Let me show you something. See, sometimes in some devices, you need to wait some time till the device becomes ready, right? All these devices, they have capacitors. أنا أذكرش زمان قديما قبل الكاميرات الحديثة كانت الكاميرات فيها فلاش. فالفلاش فيها دائما الكاميرا فيها two lights, green and red. لما مثلا تاخذ صورة تضطر تنتظر شوية حتى يتحول اللايت مرة ثانية من red لجرين حتى تاخذ الصورة الثانية. هذا طبعا بتكلم عن الكاميرات القديمة، لكن ايش؟ إذا ضغطت على الفلاش وهو الضوء الأحمر شغال ما راح يعطي فلاش. This means that that camera is naturally forming the energy. صح؟ During this process is actually doing what we call by the charging. So simply, this is two plates. One of them is positive and one of them is. These two plates, they trap the energy, the charges here, and suddenly they release it. بخزنوها بعدين ايش يا شباب؟ When they need it. So, now the process of actually here, this is a, there is a process we call by the charging and discharging. Charging actually accumulation of the charge on the plate, discharging, losing these charges from the plate. Now, this is one part of it. I want to show you something here. See, Ishma. The paraplate capacitor, this is another paraplate capacitor. If we take a small view of this one, this capacitor and this capacitor. It's mentioned here, they are not at the center exactly, see, here. They accumulate closer here, you see? And this is obvious because this is here. This negative will attract to positive. So this is the idea about this. Is this important? Yes, it's important for a reason. If we need a large potential, that potential can reach up to maybe 1,000, 5,000, or even 10,000 volt. We can get it by the capacitor. If I ask you something, did you know how much the electricity in the electric socket, how much is it? How many volt is it? You know. In the socket, it's 220 volt. You know it. You can't get, for example, you can't get 10,000 directly. So what you need? You need a tank to upload the charges in it till you get that potential difference of 10 volts, then you can use it. You forget out, Yashar. What we have from this one, from electricity, we have only 220. 110 is over now, right? So this will be here, we cannot use it for 10,000. So what we do, we just use it for charging till it becomes 10,000, then we release it. This is the idea. So please, everyone, this capacitor is just like a charge tank, is used to store the charge. So what happens, the potential difference increases to a certain height, and then we release it, as we mentioned. This process goes either by charging or discharging. Is it important? Yes. This is one of the applications I'm talking about. This is a lot of important. And one more thing. Did you know that X-ray machine is not working directly? When you're on it, you have to wait, right? This time you are waiting is actually using for charging process to become ready. See, all the giant medical, so all the medical tools that working just like MRI or X-ray, sometimes they are using the capacitor because they, to get the required here potential difference that we they work with. Okay. Is that clear for you, Shabab? Now let's go to the next point. There will be some here important. Follow me. Now E, that electric field. And we studied that. Electric field before that. It's nothing but F over Q. And the electric field here, unit is a Newton per column, okay? This electric field is a uniform electric field, as mentioned here. And this electric field, according to the capacitor, is given by, follow me, electric field is given by Q over epsilon dot A. I'll explain this for you. Q is the charge. A is the area. So the charge is column, and this is meter squared. Why the epsilon is a constant? This constant, Shabab, it depends on the type of separation here. What is it? Is it an air? Is it paper? Is it, for example, wood? So that's why we call it, Shabab, here, permittivity constant, permittivity nefadiyya. This is a constant, and this is always constant, 8.85 times 10 to the power negative 12. This is given for you here. So, this is the idea, the electric field, Q over epsilon dot A. Okay, Shabab? Now, I need to explain this for you before we proceed. Sometimes, which is confusing for some students, I can draw here the capacitor like this, Shabab. I have this plate, and this is another plate. This is almost two parallel plates. What do you mean? When I say, Shabab, I'll give you these dimensions. Of course, these plates are equal. I'm going to say, for example, this is 60 centimeter, and this is 80 centimeter, and the space between them is 2 centimeter. What is the area now? Tell me, go ahead.
For the whole thing? For the whole thing? So
no, I'm talking about the area.
Yeah. Maybe it's 480.
What is it? Say it's something times something. What is it?
18 multiplied by 60, I think.
What about 2?
No.
It's separation. Just separation, okay? 2 is not included. And what you need from the formula, this is what? Area. You know, this is the area of the blade, not the separation between the blades. So this will be, Shabab, 80 times 60. We have nothing to do with 2 centimeter. We have nothing to do with it, okay? This is only the trick that you have. If Q is easy, you can find it easy, and it's given. I'm just only this idea, and you will see now some problems regarding this one. Is that clear for you?
Yes.
Bye, Shabab. Now let me show you something. Here, as an example, we have long highway tunnels must have an air cleaners to remove dust and soot coming from the passing car and trucks. You know, this is, we have the same highway tunnels. We send ventilation in Mecca tunnels. تعرفوا المراوح الكبيرة في مكة. Right? These tunnels inside here, or these in ventilation system, these large or giant fans, they are using what? To remove the dust and soot that coming from the cars. يطلع الشباب الغبار، تسحب الغبار، وتجدد الهواء هي. شايف؟ تطلع ايش اللي هي فضلات السيارات او هي عوادم السيارات. I need to explain something. These ventilation, they are capacitors. Two parallel capacitors. Each of them, they have the same here area, but what they are one of them positive, one of them negative. We allow the here air with the suspended dust and small particles to pass through. And from the other side, what happened? These air particles, they were stuck inside. There's a filtration system. They're stuck because what? We have a kind of charging difference, positive and negative, and in the other side, what we get? Clean air. Did you know that this ventilation is very important, Shabab? If they stop, we have maybe there will be a problem in breathing oxygen, or even to actually to stay for a long time in that tunnel, right? So this is a kind of what we use it also of the capacitors. Now, I'm going to show you something. We have, this is the problem. If we have this situation like this, see, you have this one and you have this one. This is, you get the idea. We don't care about this one. Okay? If you do it directly, of course, you know that this is, here, this suffix, this is nanocoulomb, which is 10 to the power negative, 9. So if you apply the formula, think with me, Ishmael. How much the charge? 540 times 10 to the power negative over. How much epsilon naught? This is constant. How much the area now? Tell me. 0.38 times 0.206. Is that right?
Yes. Yes.
This is, we get this idea. That's straightforward. Simple. So this is an application of it. It's mentioned, air pass between the two oppositely charged metal plates as shown. What is here the magnitude of the electric field between the plates? You can easily find it like that. Okay, Shaba. We have one positive, one negative, Muhammad, but we use the positive one, of course. We don't care about the sign. We use always also the area from the dimension of the plate, not separation between the plates. This is the idea. Okay, let's go to the next point. I need to explain this along quickly to proceed. Guys, two barrel plates have charges of equal magnitude but opposite sign in front of you. What change could be made to increase the field strength between the plates? The field strength, you just write the formula. We have E. See, Yeshua, is that proportion to Q over A, right? Epsilon naught is a constant. So we say that E is that proportion to the Q, or E is inverse proportion to the area. More area would be less E. Now, what is actually here? We need, what change could be made to increase? Which one of them?
A.
Yes.
A.
Increase the magnitude of the charge. Because if we increase this Q, what's happening to E? Increase. Clear this. But see the other options. Decrease the magnitude of the charge.
What about D?
Okay. Increase, Yashikab, see. D and B, sorry, is not true. Decrease. Now, in C, increase distance between the plates. This is confusing. I said that we don't care about the distance. And finally, decrease the distance between the plates. This formula, see, this is area, has nothing about the distance. Be careful, ya Shabab, well done. We are not concerned about the distance. We are concerned about the dimension of the plates. That means the length and width only. Now I'm going to give you another example. See, Yashab, answer this question for me. Two plates of parallel plate capacitors have charges plus Q and leading to a uniform electric field between the plates. The distance between the plates is then doubled. The electric field
remains the same.
Yeah, you built now. See what is confusing? It remains the same. Why it has no relationship between the distance between the plates and the electric field? Please, this is confusing. Okay? Let's go back. Here now. Okay. Now I will talk about a little bit about the electric potential. We studied something called Gaussian potential energy. You remember we have gravitational potential energy and we have elastic potential energy. Simply, if you remember, I said that the potential energy is something we call by stored energy. Even Arabic is not Yashbab. The potential energy, gravitational, see, or the potential energy, it's better to say it's as a taqa al-kamina. What is a taqa al-wadar, Yashbab? Taqa al-wadar here, gravitational, according to the position. And a taqa al-kamina, I mean that is something inside, right? What is actually stored, this is we call by potential energy. Let me show you something. When you lift this book from here to here, you have a gravitational potential energy. So the work done by your hand is a change in gravitational potential energy. Is that right?
Yes.
Because in, now we have high potential. Now, when you compress this spring, again, the work done by your hand is a change in the elastic potential energy. Follow me, this is what I care about. Now, we have a positive charges here. And we have a positive charge here. Normally, this positive charge will never approach these due to repulsion, right? If you force it, you push it like this, from this position to this position, see a shabab here, and then release it, what happened?
It will go back.
It will go back, okay. That means, if we assume now the energy here, Shabab, here, the energy one and energy two, it's clear that energy two is greater than energy. And the proof is what? If we release it, it goes back. Right? So this is here. We say that. What is the work done here? The work done is nothing but the change in potential energy. That means U2 minus U1 between these two points. This is the change. I need to explain this clearly for you. See, Shabab. We can consider it like this. Suppose I have a positive charge, giant one. If we have here positive charge here, this positive charge will never approach this one due to repulsion. If you force it to become from here to here, I'm going to say this is UB and this is UA. You still hold it here. We assume that UB will be greater than. So the work done by you, now see, Shiva, work done is equal to change in U, which is UB minus UA. Okay? But if it is negative charge, it will move by default. You don't have to push, right? It will. Now, I'm going to say something. In which position? Now, here the energy is more. Is it A or B?
UA.
B or
yes,
A.
A is more. Because means it actually it moved by itself from A to, while it's moving, what happened to its energy? It's losing the energy, right? In this case, we say, Shabab, UA minus UB, this is your difference in energy. Why? Because UA is greater than UB. This one, no, UB is greater than? This is simple. So what we'd say, Shabab, as a jump here, we say the energy of charge, let me explain this, increases. Right? And in here, energy of charge, what happened? Yes. Charge decreases. That's why I want to say something. Sometimes, Shabab, the world could be positive or negative. World positive, man, means the energy of the object increases. And when the work negative, It means the energy of the object what? Decreases. Put this in your mind. What is a scalar? Scalar has nothing to positive, but it has some physical meaning. So please put this in. If work, this is in general. If work is positive, that means energy, I will say, of object increases. Now, if work is negative, energy of object, what happened? Decreases. According to this, I expect, here, Shabab, this work, if we follow this one, this work will be positive, and this work will be, I'm sorry, if we do the same process, UB minus UA, this work will be negative, right? Because we expect this is UA will be greater than UB. So UB minus UA will be, ask yourself, what happened to the charge? Will its energy increase, so the work positive? Its energy decrease, the work negative. Is that okay for you? Let's proceed now. Now this here, energy, we call it by the potential energy, electric potential energy. So remember, we have gravitational potential energy, UG. We have US, elastic potential energy. Now we have electric potential energy. The electric potential energy is simply, here is related to the charge. It's related to something called by electric potential. Please. Put this in your mind, Yeshba. This is electric potential energy, and this is electric potential. It's different. Now, what this means, electric potential, let me explain this for you. This is a new concept for us, that electric potential, we call it by V, Yeshba, is nothing, is equal to U, sorry, electric over Q. What this means, the electric potential is nothing but the amount of electric potential energy lost or gained by every charge. Let me see. We say this charge gain energy. How much energy gained? This is called by the electric potential. How much energy lost here? This is called by the electric potential. Now I'm going to show you something else. See you. We have delta V is equal to delta U over Q. What is the difference between this one and this one? Simple. This is here, this is electric potential. This is electric potential difference. Yeah, the difference. What is, I'm going to explain this for you. This one equal to the what? Difference in electric potential energy over
Q.
Just like what we did yesterday. Now I'm going to show you something in this regard. But this is, pay attention, Yeshua. When I say the electric potential, for example, or the potential in this room is 220 volts. That means, Yeshua, we have two wires. One of them at potential zero, one of them at potential 220. The difference between them is 220 minus zero, okay? This is what we call by potential difference. We always keep it here. Sometimes we call it by voltage, but potential is more accurate here. Now I will show you what happened. Follow me. We have a charge at A, okay? Now the charge at A, I'm gonna make here, move this charge to B, and also move this charge to C. First of all, what happened to the energy of charge at A? Will it move to B or C? Energy increases or decreases? You agree? It will increase, right? Okay, so the work done will be positive. Now, let me show you something. This is a Q is given. And this is at the energy, potential energy at A is how much is it? Okay. Is it mentioned that it takes a work of 4 microjoules? To shift from A to B. So this is the work, yes, about 4 microjoules. Is there a problem with that? Can we find, according to this, it's simply, yes, about work, as we said, is a change in electric potential energy, right? So the chain itself is equal to UB minus U. How much UA?
Zero.
So if this is here, here, we say this is zero. So it's finally it's equal to what? UB. If this is the work is four, so finally this is equal for mu. So the electric potential at the point B is equal to also four. Similarly, when we move this one to point C, the potential energy would be also six. Follow me simply. See, this is six and this is zero. Six minus zero will be positive. And this is, you have to be careful. You should know this about. The energy increases. Okay, so the work is positive. And in case the energy decreases, the work will be
minus.
Be careful, Allah Ta'ala, in this. Okay. Now we have some, it's simple, just only we apply it. I will show you here, this is given for you. The work needed to move 10 nano column charge from A to B is 4 micro. Find the electric potential energy. Electric potential energy, as we said, is equal to work from A to B. So it's 4 mu microjoule minus 0, as we said, and finally it is 4 microjoules. Similarly for the point C. Now let me give you the other case that we have. Pay attention here. Suppose, Yashkaf, here we have a point A. This is a positive charge where UA equals 0. Okay? Now we move it to point B where we have negative charges. We don't care how it moves by any means, but you should know. When it moves to point B here, this is point B, sorry, it takes a work of here minus 10, we say millijoule. Okay, how much the potential energy at B? Who can tell me, what is it?
Minus.
It's minus. It is?
Minus.
See, it is not minus 100. Let me show you. It is 10. This minus shows something. If you say UB, Shabbat, here, let me show you something. If you want to say UB is equal to 10, because, see, the difference between them, 0 to, it is 10. So this is actually, the energy is not here, is not, sorry, the energy here, it's losing minus. We said that energy, the total energy of the charge decreasing, yes, but we showed that only that level of energy is 10 compared to this level, which is zero. So in this manner, I need to show you something, Yashla. The word, if it is negative, that means the total energy of the charge decreases, and if the word is positive, that means the total energy of the charge increases. This is an idea that we have. Now we see further questions on these. But Allah, you will find that this is straightforward. You can go through it directly. So I'll read this quickly. See, we have a situation here. What is the electric potential at point B? See what is given. Potential, electric potential, that means V at V is equal to electric potential energy over U, right? We use this formula that V is equal to U electric over Q. So it could be 2 microjoule over 5 nanocoulomb. By the way, 2 over 5, it has its number. It has the same value as 4 over 10, 8 over 20, and all of them in ratio, which is 400 joule per column, all of them. This we need to know something, Ishka. Here, this number is associated here with a point B. This part depends on the charge we place at point B. This is about the Q. How much is it? Any source of charge create an electric potential at every point in the space below it. I need to say something. Here, Ishka, sometimes we have a voltage at Z, A is zero, and here is 400. So if you move from A to B, just you jump from 0 to 400, okay? This is increase in electric potential, just increase. And similarly, at any point where the electric potential V, the electric potential energy of the charge is given by U is equal to Q of V, as we mentioned. I'm sorry, it's something actually the same, we have it, but it's an idea. Right. Let's go to the problems. I think the problems will be more apparent for us. You will see how easy is it. This question, by the way, is straightforward. A 15 nanocoulomb charge particle moved from point A, where the electric potential is 300 volt, to point B, where the electric potential is negative 200 volt. Okay? Now, there is a question. The question is, by how much does the electric potential change? We need to find the Shabab. By how much does the electric potential change? How much does it be now? Just say it.
250 to 100.
Minus 500.
Yeah, it's minus 500. Minus 200 Shabab. Minus. So it is minus 500 volt. Simple, you know that. This is natural. Now, the second one of them. There's nothing about Yeshiva, there's some explanation for the negative energy. See, by how much does the particle's potential energy changes? Now we need that U. U itself is equal to V, sorry, delta U is equal to delta V times Q, right? Q now, how much is it? So this is 15 times 10 to the power negative now. How much this one now? It's? Yeah, okay. It is negative or positive. Tell me, Shabab. Here, you may ask me, the energy, is it a scalar? It's always positive. But here, in this situation only, we use a negative and positive for a reason. This is mean, Shabab. When it's moved from 300 to minus 200.
So it's losing you.
Yeah, the potential decreases. This is the potential. So what happened to the energy? Also decreases. Of course, if we times this by this, will give me this value. Minus 7.5 times 10 to the power negative 6. This is the idea. So please, Ashraf, I want to say something. This is not a contradiction to you. We know that the scalar is always positive. Always. But in this case, work and energy could be positive or negative. It has a physical meaning. Well, it could be positive, that means the energy increases. Or negative, that means the energy decreases. That's it. Don't tell me this is all. This is a direction up or down, or right or left. No. We don't care about this one. We care about the amount of energy. If it increases, it's positive, or decreases, it's negative. Okay, Shabab.
I know it's a little bit hard for you, these ideas.
Fine. This is a very good example, because this happened inside your body. We have the membrane potential of a cell is caused by an imbalance of the potassium and sodium ions. This potassium and sodium ions, they are very important. That's why we have to minimize the sodium ions, so minimize taking in the salts, and take more potassium ions, which is, by the way, there are many food sources of potassium, just like banana. It's a good source of potassium. What I need, this is inside the cell. This is the cell wall, and this is outside the cell. Follow me, Shabab. Inside the cell, the potential difference or the electric potential is minus 70. At the wall, outside the cell, how much is it?
Zero.
It's zero. By the way, when it moved from minus 70 to zero, this is increasing, okay? So what happened here? Potential is minus 70 and outside, where the potential is zero. Let me see the question. What is the change in the ions, electric, potential, energy, okay? So. Now, what is the change it will be? Yalla, Shabab. How much the here the change in electric potential from 0 minus minus 70, right? So it will be
70.
Okay, that's it. So you will see simply straightforward. Now, see, it is this one, 0 minus minus 70. Of course, we convert this one. So this is 0 minus minus 70. So finally, it's plus 70 millivolt. This is an ion. Did you know that potassium, how much ion is it? One. So its charge, how much is it? Charge of proton, 1.6. In case, if I give you, for example, calcium, 2 plus, the charge will be, Ashba, 2 times 1.6 times 10 to the power negative, 19. Okay? If I gave you aluminum, 3 plus, what happened to you? 3 times the same thing. Did you know what? Now, you know why it is 1.6?
The charge of the electron.
Yes, it is just only one. See, it is plus one, right? It means it has one proton or losing one electron. You got the point? And we apply the formula. This is it. And finally, see, Shabab, does the ion's energy increase or decrease? It
increases.
Yeah, it's gone from minus 70 to
zero.
So it increases. Right, 100%. And by the way, can you see why it is increases? See the value. Is it positive or negative?
Positive.
That means increases. Please, Asha, stick to this. I know it's a little bit hard, this section. But, well, it's a very, very good chance, Asha, for you to have a good mark on it. Okay. We have the formula. This is maybe the last part. We're done. Pay attention now. We have now, let's go back to the capacitor. In the capacitor, we say we have two plates. These two plates, they have different potential, electric potential. Maybe we can say this is 0 volt and this is 10 volt. So how much is the difference in potential? 10 between them, okay? Now, can we find this about how much the potential at a certain distance from one of the plates? Yes, we can find it. If we say, Shabab, here the situation, this is here 0 joule, and we just push it from here to here. Well, the distance is x. The total distance is d. You follow?
Mm-hmm.
How much the potential at x equals? See, potential at x equals x over d times change in potential. What is the change in potential we made here? It's 10 volt. This is x, could be for example 7, and this is 10. 7 over 10 times straightforward. This is, we use it to find the electric potential at any point inside the capacitor, between the plates. At any point. I need to say something, Ishba. If we assume this is 0, and this is 10, and all of you, follow me, Shabab. We can say this is 2 volt. Then this is 4 volt. This line, 6 volt. Then this line, 8 volt. And finally, the last will be. So, this is, by the way, we call it that equipotential lines. At this point, any here, this position, it's 2 volt. Now, this position, we say it's 6 volt. This position is 8 volt, and so on. It is an ion. So V is equal to X over D times change in electric potential. Now, the electric field, this is the last point. Electric field is nothing but the change in electric potential over D. The electric field will change here and over D. This, by the way, how we derive it is not required. I know you may ask how this come. But we derive it from the previous one, Yeshua. Just like, if you remember now, we taught that E is equal to Q over epsilon naught A, right? And we just find an underlay. Now we have E here is equal to what? Change in electric potential over D. By the way, C, this is stand for capacitor. If you skip it, it's okay. There is nothing about it. Change in here, electric potential over D. Now these two, they are equivalent. Right? since this is E and this is E, we can say Q over epsilon A is equal to delta V over D. Now, D, this one, is a separation between the blades. Why, this is area, area of every plate, okay? Put this in mind. Now we will take some examples. I know there's a lot of details here, but what to do, Yeshua? I'm going to start from here, from below. Follow me, Yeshua. We mentioned that electric is equal to Q over epsilon A, right? Is equal to change in V over D. Now, I would consider only this one, these two together. Make a Q as the subject. Q, we send this up, so epsilon A over D times delta B, okay? This is, ask yourself, this is all of it. Is it constant?
Yes.
By the way, Shant, yes. Let me show you something. Epsilon naught is constant, okay? Depend on the type of insulator. A, we keep that always, the blades has a constant area. We're not changing it. And the separation also we consider to be constant. So all this constant has one word, which is called by C. This C, by the way, Shabab, is the capacitance of capacitor. Sa'at al-mukaffif, capacitance. So in general, we have this formula. Q is equal to C, or you can say C is equal, Shabab, Q over delta V. This capacitor, I need to tell you a story about it. This capacitor is just like a charge tank. What you use? You use to store the charge in it. This charge has, or this tank has a capacity, right? Just like everything. You can, for example, store 100 charge in it, or you can store, for example, 100,000 charge, according. Just like, for example, the cars. Some cars, they have 5 passengers capacity. Some cars, they are 7. Some count maybe more, right? This is what we say. So the capacity depends on the charge, and this is clear. More charge means more capacity. And also, it depends on the change in electric potential. More electric potential, we have less capacity. Now, I need to say something. This value, coulomb per volt, there's a new formula or a new unit for you. It's called by Farad. This unit. You should know it, Shabab. And the SI unit of capacitance is farad. Farad is equal to coulomb per volt. Okay? Per volt. We don't have that. Okay, Shabab, barakallahu feek. Now, if you ask me, all these formulas, Shabab, always, in any problem, write the details that you have and see what is the closest thing. Sometimes you need to get something and then use it in another form. It's two steps question, it could be. Now we see some examples, because I think you always done it. This is VIP about this. Okay. I'm looking for problems. I'll come back to you. Never mind. This is the last point, Ishbar, here, finish. Now the electric potential energy is stored in a capacitor with charge Q and potential difference. Now this energy is given in another formula. It's equal to Q squared over 2C. I know that, Ishbar, this is a lot of laws, I know, but what we do? That electric potential energy of a capacitor is equal to Q squared over 2C. If you remember something, Ishbar, you took this last year. You remember force spring that we have force spring as example, force is equal to K delta X. You remember this?
Yes.
K is stiffness or spring constant. Okay, US is equal to half K delta X squared. This is the energy stored in the spring. Okay? The same manner we say, Shabab, the energy stored is equal to half Q squared over C. Of course, instead of that, you can say Q itself is equal to what? Is equal to, we mentioned that it's C times delta V. Or now we just took it, C is itself is equal to Q over delta V, right? So Q is equal to C times delta V. Replace this by C squared delta V squared. And you have C, so what happened this C with C? You have one C, and what? Delta V squared, this is simple. This will give you about the energy of the electric potential stored inside the capacitor. Now, let me stop here. I see the influence of the lecture. By the way, always we struggle in this lesson. كل سنة من إحنا بنعاني من هذا اللسن يا شباب. إنه I know that it's not linked. Sometimes you are losing a little bit. But see, what is good for you? You will have the information here, and you just do it. So, for example, if you need u squared, u is equal to u squared over 2c. If u is not given, you can get u from another resource. That's it. You just match the formula and you just find it. Allah Yaqeen, you stop here, shall. In the next week, yeah, Shabab, you go through the questions. In the next week, if you have anything, we go through it, inshallah ta'ala, because this is everything for today. We expect next week will be the last lecture, inshallah ta'ala, of course. Shukran, ya Shabab.